Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about Snowflake Data Warehouse. Snowflake organizes the data into multiple micro partitions that are internally optimized and compressed. It uses a columnar format to store the data in the cloud storage and work as a shared disk model. Snowflake allows corporate users to store and analyze data using cloud-based hardware and software. And it's majorly used on Amazon AWS, Microsoft Azure, and Google Cloud Platform. In this video, we are going to see some examples with hands-on about Snowflake. Bring a solution as software as a service with full support of ANSI SQL. It also has a unique architecture that enables user to just create a table and start querying data with very less administration and DBA activities. Snowflake combines a completely new SQL query engine with an innovative architecture natively designed for the cloud. And it's offering important three features to us. First, there is no hardware to select, install, and configure. And there is no software to install and configure. And upcoming maintenance and management, everything will be taken care of by Snowflake team. Snowflake's unique architecture consists of three key layers, which are database storage, query processing, and cloud services. In database storage, Snowflake reorganizes the data into internal optimized, compressed, and columnar format. In query processing, query execution is performed in the processing layer. Snowflake processes the query using virtual warehouse. In each virtual warehouse is an MPP compute, cluster compost, and multiple compute nodes allocated by the Snowflake. And the third one is cloud services. The cloud service layers is a collection of services that coordinate activities across the Snowflake. And this service is maintained by authentication, infrastructure management, metadata management, and access control. While you activate the Snowflake account, you will get account name, region, username, and password. Based on that, you can connect to the Snowflake in different ways. We are going to see that one by one now. First is web user interface. It's a web console. So based on that, we can connect and we can interact our query at runtime. In this video, completely we'll follow with web console for the understanding practice. And upcoming videos will be follow other steps one by one. Next, Snow SQL. So it will help to connect via command line prompt. So you have to install this application and then you can connect via command line. And ODBC and JDBC driver, based on that you can connect and transfer your data. And native connector, while developing the Snowflake, they are developing that native connector support for Python and Spark. Based on that, you can connect and you can transfer it. And third party connector, which is help to connect with some ETL operation. Once you activate your Snowflake account, you can connect via your account URL and you can pass your username and password here to enter into the environment. If all your connection matched successfully, you can see your username here with respect to some particular role. By default, sysadmin is a kind of role they will give you. If suppose you want to grant access to some other and role will be vary, depends on that. On that left side, these tabs are help to interact with your warehouse environment and databases will be reflect in the left side. Here, what are the databases you are using, that will be reflect and you can utilize it directly. Shares will help to interact with your data from multiple locations or multiple cloud services. Data marketplace will help to interact with your third-party connectors. Warehouses, depends on your data, you can create multiple warehouses and that will be stored from XSMALL to X4 large. Depends on that, you can select and you can use it. And worksheet, which is actually you're going to execute all your command, that will come to this body line. In this place, you can execute all your command with respect of your schema selections and database selections. Once you execute your query, all the outcome will see in the result tab. If suppose you want to add a new worksheet, click on the plus symbol and you can add it. Now we will see how to create a virtual warehouse using Web Console. So this is the command I am going to execute, and I just mentioned the size of that warehouse and how long this will be sustained. If suppose it will be crossed more than this time, then automatically that warehouse is going to be terminated and it will be come out from that environment. Based on the warehouse, the charges will be applied. So you can select this as per your data sizes and you can utilize it. Once I executed this, and I can see that warehouse has created successfully in that result tab. If suppose I want to select the warehouse, you can use the command use warehouse and warehouse name and click on run button. It will execute and it will be entered into the particular environment. Once you create the data warehouse, you can create the database using this command. Create or replace database name, and then click on the run button. It will be executed and the result will be showing you, and then you can just refresh your database and then your database will be reflecting to the left tab. Once you create the database, you can select using the command via use database and database name. Otherwise you can select based on the drill down in web UI. I'm going to select HelloDB for this upcoming practices. Here in this hello table I'm going to create, this is a table will come under to HelloDB, and this is the command. I have used three columns, one as an integer, another two as a string, and then I just execute, and you can see the table has created successfully and it will be reflect under to the HelloDB on public schema. Once table has created, I can execute insert into command and create that. This command will be directly insert a record into the warehouse table, or you can interact via your cloud services like AWS, Azure or GCP storage spaces. Both will be possible. Once you execute this command, you can see how many records are available. You can reflect in that result tab. That's it on this video, and we will see the continuity in upcoming videos one by one. Thank you all.